our disposition in terms of working with students. In the first one, we have a talk about, sorry, did I get your copy in this reading? Okay, anyway, it's out there. Here in our reading, it says that every teacher has to do with the education of young students. Every teacher who has to do with the education of young students should remember that children are affected by the atmosphere that surrounds the teacher, whether it be pleasant or unpleasant. And this not only implies in the classroom, it also implies on us at home. If we bring a cheerful disposition, an attitude of happiness, this actually impacts on family members, and also when we step in the class, this will have an impact on our students. Although in this reading we have the word young children, this also applies to us working with college students. So if we are happy and we show it in class, our students will also take on that spirit. On the other hand, if we come in irritated, if we come in with a sour face, long, the students will also feel that in them. The teachers who work in this part of the Lord's Vineyard need to be self-possessed to keep their temper and feelings under control. And this is in relation with allowing the Holy Spirit to live in us, and so that we will be able to share good information to our students in a good tone of voice. Now, how are teachers able to do this? This is simply when all teachers actually learn from the school of Christ. We will be educated by that from the great teacher. Self-cultured, self-possessed, under discipline to Christ, having a living connection with the great teacher, teachers will have an intelligent knowledge of practical religion and keeping their own souls in the love of God. They will discern that they have the most important field in the Lord's Vineyard to cultivate. They will lift the heart to God in the sincere prayer, Lord, be thou my pattern. That is a very good prayer. And I'm sure all of us actually start our day doing our professional responsibility by saying that too. Lord, that means we want God to be the model for us, and that we will show in us. Well-balanced minds and symmetrical characters are required of teachers in every line. So whatever our responsibility, here we are reminded again that we have to have balance, well-balanced minds. And this means that we, again, do not only think about the curricular information that we need to share with our students, but it has to be based on religious backing. That's why in our institution we have this term, character building. So, by sharing what we know we need to share, whatever our subjects may be,